Hi everyone, welcome back. I'm sort of back, I guess. I don't know. We will see. I decided I need to do another video. I haven't done one of these videos in a very, very long time. And with everything that is going on in the world right now, I thought this is the perfect moment to get back into filming, to get back into talking to you guys about cameras, about photography, about random stuff. So today is going to be a bit of a random one, mainly because it relates to what I want to talk to you guys. I've seen a lot of people online, I had a lot of chats with my friends and everybody that is a creative, that not necessarily in photography, but musicians, artists, painters, everybody is struggling a little bit at the moment. And I absolutely understand it. We all are cooped up in our houses. We can't go out and see people. We can't go out and get inspiration. We can't go out and take pictures. But we should find ways to keep being creative. Now, don't get me wrong. If you just feel like having a day or two or three or a week where you just want to sit on the sofa, just go and sit on the sofa, watch Netflix, watch YouTube, watch me, hey, you know. You don't have to put yourself down if you're not feeling in the mood or if you're not feeling creative. You don't need to feed into this pressure that I keep seeing online that, oh, it's lockdown, it's the perfect moment to be creative and create and do things. We're not all the same. We all react to these things in a different way, and that's absolutely fine. I was in that moment. I was in that sofa couch place where I just sat on the sofa and I watched Netflix for days in a row without doing anything creative at all, just because I didn't feel like it. And I was feeling tired and I was missing having people to talk to and going out and taking pictures. But I decided that today is gonna be the day I'm gonna change that. And here I am, making a video, talking about how to get back into being creative, or how to get back into a creative mindset. I don't know. I've been thinking about this video a lot, and I know it's gonna be a bit of a random one. I have another one planned where I will be talking about this little camera, which I tested a while back. My phone is falling down. And I have a couple of shots with me using the camera, putting the film in. I have the images developed already. So that's gonna come up soon. So, you know, subscribe, comment, share, all that good stuff. But that's not what I'm gonna talk about today. I'm making this video mainly because I wanna push myself and challenge myself to get out of that routine, let's call it. You wake up, you turn on your computer, you watch some video games, maybe you watch a Netflix series, then you watch another one, then you eat something, then it's late at night, then you go to bed, and the next day the same thing happens. So I have been looking online at a couple of different things that I could be doing and a couple of different ideas of how to get out of this not inspirational moment, mood, call it whatever you want. I have a couple of notes here, but I'm not necessarily gonna go through them. This is gonna be probably a one take video. Hopefully it's not gonna take too long to edit either. We'll see. I'm a bit rusty on that. But I'm doing it. And that's what's important. So the first thing and the first advice I can give to you, if you want to get out of that non-creative mood, is to just do it. Get the camera out, go have a walk around your neighborhood, set yourself a challenge to go out and take pictures of something, of anything, sky, trees, grass, dogs. There's a lot of people walking their dogs, so there's a very, very big opportunity there to have some pictures of dogs. Why not? There are a couple of photographers online that are doing photography challenges. I'm actually doing a sort of photography challenge with three of my friends. They're all photographers, they're all very creative, and you know who you are. And we set up this challenge to come up with a theme, and each of and every single one of us will have to create an image within that theme. And this week it was shadows, and we all created an image that was related to shadows or had something to do with shadows. And it just makes you think a little bit differently. If you don't have friends, or if you don't have a group of other creative people that you can do this with, I found this girl online on YouTube and on Instagram, and she's an inspiration when it comes to being creative and getting out of your comfort zone. Her name is Kika, and I'm gonna link her YouTube in the description and Instagram and all that, but she's doing a photo challenge. So this is the workbook that she put together. You can download it from free from her website. And it has a couple of ideas that you can go through, and every week is going to be like a 12-week challenge, and you have to go along with the ideas. I think this week the challenge is to take a picture that takes you back to childhood. Haven't done it yet, but I have a couple of ideas, so I'm excited to try that out. So you will get this workbook with a couple of information, and you will have some bits and pieces where you will have to add your own information and answers to a couple of questions related to, you know, what gets you going, what makes you creative and all that. And I think this is brilliant. I bet there are other people out there doing challenges like this that you can just sign up. Most of them are going to be for free, and you just you feel, first of all, being part of a community, you feel accounted for because you decide to take part in the challenge, and then it kind of gets you going. The hardest step is just to sit down and decide, okay, I'm gonna do it. Once you've done that, it gets very, very easy. So that's one thing. Find a challenge. Challenge yourself. I'm very, very competitive when it comes to anything, really. So having a challenge and putting it out there, if you have an Instagram, a Facebook account, anything like that, just put it out there, say it, say you're gonna do the challenge. That way you know that you're accounted for, you know that people will expect you to follow up with the challenge, and they will expect to see the results from your challenge. And then just do it. You might not feel like it. I didn't feel like filming today. I really wanted to see my friend because she wanted to walk her dogs, and I love dogs, but I decided no, I will sit down and I'll film this video and we'll walk the dogs another day. So I'm sorry, Julia, I'm really, really sorry. Next one is find a book that will inspire you, or find a book about something that can get your creative juices flowing. I recently found this book here, which has arrived very, very fast. It's all about the process of getting the image printed by Ansel Adams. And I find that fascinating because when we think about analog photography, most of the people will say something like, oh yes, analog photography is so much better because there was no editing involved and everything has to be done in the camera, and then, you know, that's the original, that's the purest form of photography. Well, this book kinda teaches you the opposite thing. Yes, taking the image, making sure the image is right in the camera is very important, but getting the print out, if you're gonna develop the image yourself, or getting the print out in terms of editing the image, editing the raw format that you have, putting it in Lightroom, Photoshop, Capture One, whatever you have, it's as important. So this book is all about the process that Ansel Adams had when it came to printing his images, how he, let's say, edited them in Darkroom. And it really, really inspired me to try and do some different things with my edits. And recently I have been working on that, and probably if you guys have been following me for a while on Instagram, again, links and stuff wherever, here in comments section, description, you will see that my editing style has changed a little bit. And that's because I'm learning how to do things differently, how to do them better, how to do them in a different way. So that's the second thing that I think is important when it comes to getting back on that creative saddle. Just try and learn a new technique, try and learn a new skill when it comes to your hobby, learn something new when it comes to taking the pictures, experiment. If you're lucky enough and you have to stay home and you don't have to go to work, this is the perfect moment. Get your head in a book or go on YouTube and Google something. Go on YouTube and search for, you know, different editing techniques, or how to create pop art, or how to create, I don't know, collages. Learn something new. Once you start, again, the starting point is the most important one, but once you start, I bet you will not have those lazy days on the couch watching Netflix anymore. So get creative in terms of learning new skills, in terms of learning how to do things in a different way. Why not? Another thing that helped me a lot, hence why I'm now sitting down and filming, and you can see my background has changed a little bit. I still have the bookcase with all my books and cameras and stuff, but you can see that it's a slight different angle, is that I actually rearranged my office the other day. I didn't feel inspired anymore in the way that the office was laid out before. So I decided I'm gonna move the furniture around, have a change. When we go to work, for example, or where we are, when we are not stuck in the house, you get to experience, visit other places, see other things, and then you come home and the home is gonna be this oasis where you just, it's just you with yourself and you relax and you enjoy the place. When you get stuck in that place for a really, really long time, it can get a bit boring, let's say. I wasn't feeling inspired in my office anymore. I wasn't feeling like I can now sit down at my desk and edit, or I can sit down and read, or I can take some interesting images. So I just moved my furniture around. If you have that possibility, if you can, just move stuff around a little bit. It will break the routine, it will make the space feel different, and hopefully it will help you get started. And the last thing that I want to touch on is try not to put yourself down. If you're not feeling creative, if you're feeling sad and, I don't know, depressed. I don't want to use the word depressed because it's such a big and heavy word, and you know, I know a lot of people are, and it is a very tough situation that we are all in. But if you don't want to do things, if you don't want to get creative, just take it slow, relax, sit on that couch, watch those Netflix movies. And when you feel, because there will be one point, if you're a creative person, I guarantee there will be one point, one morning, you will wake up and you will want to do something. Give that moment wings. Just get up and decide that you're going to do something creative on that day. Go and find a photo challenge. Move things around in your office. Try and learn a new skill, or try and do something a little bit different with your art. It doesn't have to be photography, whatever that is. But if you have that tiny, tiny feeling that you want to do something a little bit different, just live up to it and then decide on that day that you will do something. If not, wait until it will come. And I assure you, it will come really, really soon to you, and you will want to do stuff, you will want to do creative. And follow all those people that are telling you, oh, this is such a beautiful day and I'm feeling inspired and blah blah blah. And follow them. if they make you sad, just stop watching them. Take a break from social media. Take a break from electronics. Read a book. Find that book that you loved when you were a child and read that book again. Take time for yourself, because as tough as this, you know, whole pandemic is, it is pretty great. I mean, you get to experiment new things. You get to be with yourself for longer than before, and something good must come out of it. That was all for this video. I hope you guys found it interesting. I don't know, I hope so. To me, it was more a challenge to put myself out there again and do something creative instead of thinking of doing something creative. So I hope you guys enjoyed it. And really, really soon we'll have the video about the Vito B, and I hope you guys will like that as well. Like, share, subscribe, comment, you know, the things that cool kids do this day. And yeah, until next time.